I'm a big man, but I'm not 30. Missy and I might watch me get dirty, murky. Oh my god, I swear I should have been a rapper. Guess what? It was my birthday. Guess how old I turned? Okay, I'm gonna give you a clue. Give you a little clue, just a little one. My balloons are too big for my legs. Can you? Guys, I turned 25. I'm officially a quarter life century. Yeah, I'm old. I'm a grandma. Look. Wow. Look at this balloon. The balloon floating away just like my life. I don't even want it. No, I'm joking. My sister bought that for me, actually. I appreciate that. So funny, right? Another year, another blessing. Every day I take, I get closer to my goal. So I'm one of them people who actually like getting older, because you know, I feel like I'm one step closer to meeting Jesus and to getting to my goal. So yeah, it's all good. My birthday last week, I turned 25, and it was so good. It was like the most amazing birthday ever. So it was on the 26th of March, Mother's Day. I went to Paris on the Friday for like 2 nights, 48 hours. You know I love Paris, like j'adore Paris. Was that good? So it was like five man deep, squaw, like it was just, it was litty committee, it was like booyah, like amazing. I didn't actually get to like vlog it or film anything just because I was quite intoxicated and I just wanted to enjoy my birthday, you know? You know when you like, you're having so much fun that you just don't have time to like, you know, video or take pictures. But I have a lot of Snapchat, so I think I might put some of my Snapchat videos at the end. And then on the Sunday when I got back, like, yeah, so I went on Friday and I came back on the Sunday morning, and I was so drunk. I got on the plane drunk. I was thrown up on the plane. I don't know how it happened. I have footage, so it obviously did happen, and I'm here, so I obviously did make it, but only, it's only God that knows how this thing happened. But yeah, guys, I made it. I had a small gathering at my house on Sunday, a few close family friends, Jollof, you know, and actually made this outfit on the day I came back. Again, I don't know how I did it. I'll show you guys quick. It's me. See these like trousers on the day I came back, because I just didn't know what to wear. It's so bad, like I haven't even, the waist is quite bad. I was tired. I beg. But yeah, so that was my birthday. But it's so crazy, you know what, now I'm 25, it's like, you know when you start to deep your life, like I'm not a baby girl anymore. Like, I'm not a baby girl. I'm not a baby girl. It's crazy. When you turn 18, it's like, oh my god, yeah, I can go out. I don't have to like borrow anyone's ID. It's so amazing. But you still feel like you're not a woman yet. Or I don't know, maybe it was just me. I felt like I'm still kind of like a girl. I'm in college or just going to uni, whatever. 21, I was like, I'm not a girl, I'm not a little girl no more. But I didn't quite feel like a woman. It was like that in between stage, not a girl, not quite, not yet a woman. Nah, you see now, yeah, man's a big woman, man's a big man. Like, I really do feel like a woman, and it's hit me, and the responsibilities to come, like, I'm excited for it. I'm excited for the next chapter of my life. Like, Missy 2.5, let's do this. One of the things that does come with being 25 is, you know, you already know, guys. When will you marry? That's all I hear. When will you marry? All your friends are having babies. See them, they're marrying men, and you're here. Oh, guy, when will you marry? When will you marry? All your friends, they're married with husband and you're here. What are you doing on social media? Hey, is this your life? Guys, This is abuse, you know. I don't, if you're African, you'll understand what I'm talking about. The mental abuse of being single. It's like a sin. You're not allowed to be single in African households above the age of 25. This message is from one of my friends who's a guy. He was like, happy birthday, Missy. God bless you, my G. Listen, find yourself a boyfriend now, yeah? Safe. Because I don't have a boyfriend.
Are you sure?
I'm sure, Dad. I don't have a boyfriend.
Okay.
I'm gonna let you in on a little secret, yeah? And this may shock some of you, but I don't want a boyfriend. I actually do not want a boyfriend. I never knew when it became by force to want a boyfriend. I love being single so much. Like, not even the fact that, like, I'm single and dating, because I actually don't like dating either. I've actually got like a phobia of dating. That's for another video. But I'm not out here talking to guys. I just like being independent, and I do feel like maybe I am too independent. But I'm not looking for a boyfriend. What I do want, or like wouldn't mind to find, is a partner in crime, a fellow independent guy who's about his business, on his shit, to like, you know, come together as one. Like, I think people need to understand there's a difference between having a boyfriend and having like a partner. And at 25, if anyone tells you they want a boyfriend, and they mean like boyfriend, then okay. Like, I'm at this stage where I'm trying to get assets, I'm trying to build, I'm trying to get houses, houses, cars, like, you know, going forward to raising a family. I'm not looking for a boy to do this with, because these are not boy things. These are manly things. I need a partner, someone who has backbone, who has strength to carry what's gonna come. So when it comes to choosing a boyfriend, I take it quite seriously. And not to say that I'm picky, because I'm actually really not. I'm not those, he has to be 6'2", green eyes, Nigerian, like, I don't even, any, like,
I wouldn't mind if
we all bleed
though.
It's not that deep, but there's certain characteristics you need to have, and not only that, you need to have it, I need to have it. Are you ready to be a partner to someone else? Are you ready to be wifey? Not wife, I said wifey, but with wifey comes wife, because at my age, when you're getting into a relationship, we're not getting into a relationship for bants. You're not gonna be like, yeah, I'll do him till Christmas, then I'll lock him off and then find the next thing. Like, no, we're really trying to pursue something serious out here. So you have to be really, really diligent when you're dealing with these things. And it's like, okay, what do I want from a guy? There's certain qualities, okay. But that kind of caliber of guy, what would he want in a female? Am I that female? Am I there yet? Like, is it really gonna work? You have to really ask yourself. And that's why I feel like, you know, it really boils down to, take your time with this, guys. It's hella serious. Hella. But yeah, I always say this, but I'm 25, but I'd rather get married at 35 to the right person than at 25 to the wrong person and get divorced. Because nobody's got time for that. Nah, like, deep it. Like, would you rather? Like, if I could tell myself one thing as a 25-year-old, looking back at myself, my younger self, it would definitely be like, don't worry. Like, everything will be okay in the end. And if it's not okay, then it's just not the end. Like, God's got you. Don't stress it. So guys, I'm excited. Let's do this. Subscribe, share, Twitter, tweet, like, Instagram. What, I said it already. Do it. Just share the thing in it. Like, don't be selfish. Why are you selfish for? Can you share? You see, I'm gonna fight with you, balloon. I don't understand. This is like, what is, bruv.
Wait, I bring them, give them my phone number.
Why?
I need to access them now.
You know, it's 2017. They don't do diary anymore.
Yeah?
They don't do diary. They don't. No one's killing a cow for me.
Hello. Oh, sorry.
Wow.
One time for the birthday, bitch. One time. Two times for the birthday, bitch.
One time. more God, more money, more everything, more
Sunday.
So, for the beautiful girl, I wish you are your Danny birthday. Happy birthday.
Fuck it up if it's your birthday, bitch. Fuck it up if it's your birthday, bitch.